Australia and its surrounding countries of Southeast Asia have long had an exploitative relationship with the sea. Indigenous people have been living and fishing around the island continent centuries before Europeans colonized the island.
The species of shark, the scalloped hammerhead, has a historical range prolific throughout the Timor, Arafura, and Coral Sea. While the shark is notable throughout the coasts of most countries in between and slightly beyond the tropics of Cancer and Capricorn, this area is a contentious spot for this species. The scalloped hammerhead has been labeled as conservation dependent by Australia. The shark is, however, allowed to be fished in the region.
A point of human and ethical rights in the region lies with the Bahau, a community that has a deep history with the seas above Australia. While communities would participate in agricultural practices, their main source of nutrition was the sea. While fishing accounted for a huge portion of their diet, shark was also a significant resource. Fishermen would hunt sharks primarily for survival. However, there is evidence that shark and other valuable seafaring products have been plundered from the Timor Sea for hundreds of years to be sold in Chinese markets. The Sea of Timor had been fished for shark fin soup as early as the 14th century. The fin is prized as a delicacy, while the rest of the body is likely thrown back into the sea.
When sharks are commercially fished for only their fins, the shark meat needs to go through a cleansing process, since sharks urinate through their skin. Since this causes a strong ammonia smell and a foul flavor, very few people are willing to eat shark body meat, meaning that it isn't profitable to take whole bodies of the shark back to the port. With a rise in consumer demand in the late 60s and early 70s, shark fins became more and more valuable to the fishermen of the Timor Sea. The Australian government tried to address the issue of overexploitation in their legislation, enacting this 1974 Memorandum of Understanding, an agreement between Australia and Indonesia. This gave access to the Bahau in designated zones in Australian waters.
This gave the Bahau the ability to continue with traditional fishing practices such as hand lines and shark rattles, allowing their culture to continue in a more industrial age. However, this ruling also gave Indonesian fishing vessels the ability to exploit the deeper, more untouched waters of the Timor with more modernized technology. By targeting deeper waters, the scalloped hammerhead was hit particularly hard.
It needs to be understood that just like cuts of beef being priced differently in the United States, different sharks are priced accordingly in the Chinese shark fin soup. Hammerhead fins are actually some of the lesser valued fins on the market. The scalloped hammerhead, however, acts in a way that somewhat negates this lower value of fin. These specific hammerhead sharks travel in schools throughout the ocean. The ability for these Indonesian fishermen to fish deeper waters, where larger and more hammerheads congregate, and have larger fishing lines gave them the ability to devastate the population of scalloped hammerheads. According to the Australian Marine Conservation Society, as of 2014, 370 tons of hammerhead sharks had been caught every year.
Following many other countries, in November of 1979, Australia extended their Australian fishing zone from 12 nautical miles to 200 nautical miles. This had a direct effect on the Bahau population. With new restrictions to the Bahau, they were forced to adapt to a new situation. Reports from the 80s indicated that all Bahau boats were using hand lines and shark rattles. By 1990, shark rattles had been deemed worthless as they could no longer attract the sharks in deeper waters where they were allowed to fish. While the Bahau struggled to continue their cultural and traditional fishing techniques, commercial fishermen around the region utilize over-exploitative measures.
As recently as December of 2019, an Indonesian fishing vessel had been caught in Australian exclusive economic zone with fishing gear and 14 tons of fresh and frozen sharks and fin fish. While the process of finning a shark is illegal in Australia, it is not illegal to sell or buy shark fins imported from overseas locations in Australia. The species is listed as critically endangered by the IUCN Red List. However, there are multiple conservation actions not taken to protect the species.
Our first proposed solution for the shark is to be listed as threatened by the Environment Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act of 1999. This would make it illegal to fish for the scalloped hammerhead in Australian law. On the northeastern coast of the country, off of Queensland, lies the Great Barrier Reef. This is valued at $56 billion and adds billions to the economy every year. Sharks play a pivotal role in this ecosystem, acting as apex predators. An abundance of sharks means a healthy environment. While the Great Barrier Reef is battling situations such as climate change and reef bleaching, adding the hammerhead to the EPBC Act would be an excellent starting point for a healthier coral reef. The Bahau should be given exclusive designated shallow fishing grounds where limited and monitored sharking for personal and community use is allowed.
Ever since the movie Jaws, the fear of sharks and shark attacks has grown exponentially. Shark control groups were put into place with nets and drum lines to quell the fear and decrease the chance of human-shark interactions. The equipment used catches more than the targeted species, and Dr. Lee Gibbs at the University of Wollongong has found that the tactics used by shark control groups is both ineffective at keeping people safe and have negative effects on marine life. 94% of animals caught were non-targeted species, including rays, turtles, dolphins, and harmless fish. They also caught non-targeted shark species such as hammerheads and grayner sharks. Our second solution involves abolishing these shark control groups and replacing them with non-lethal programs. Replacing shark control groups with programs such as tagging, drone surveillance, and shark education would be more effective and safer for the ocean and non-targeted species.
While the scalloped hammerhead seems to have everything in the world going against it, the Australian government has the ability to create a precedent for protection of this worldwide species. Hopefully, the country can initiate the proper procedures to allow these beautiful schools of shark to continue swimming in their waters for centuries.